Is there an easy unified by path? And I hooked up. The last thing you want to do is to follow the instructions. They're really easy. Pick yourself a hand down, or a steering table, or a gender of mine. You can solve all power supply. You probably only got an industry with an engine running test can and a cigarette. Well, that was it. And it's like you said, I wired it in. All you do is answer two questions. Number of cylinders, how many duty tensions, you power it out of speed, those kinds of things. It takes you through step by step. And then it'll tell you to put you in the base metal to start the thing. You power it up where it can get the temperature, it goes through the turning process, it runs in. That's the beauty of this thing. So, the deal I will follow through forward here, and what this is, same job building, we're going to wrap it up, all proceeds go to the W Sound and Main Society, start off with a 347 horsepower rated trailer and get completed. 30 over 5, a 302, it's 5 rated. It's got Ford pistons, Ford driving rods, 21 compression, aluminum G240 heads, G303 roller cam, we're going to lift it across, steel pushrods, roller rockers, beautiful power drive covers. You know, there's power fin take on it. EVEFI, follow body shop, MTI distributor, nice and wide, whatever you need. There's certainly not easy on engine testing. I got a couple of these that work great. This one, you know, they're on the web. This is truly up for blue, even if it's special for the American family. Step 4 dashboard. You got fuel tank, a radiator with a cool fan, battery, everything you need to run an engine. I run it, it just runs great. It's got an upgrade. You got water temperature, oil pressure, and voltage. I've got the engine up, you can still get it. Probably at 130 or 140 degrees already. Got a master power system to turn it on, the gauge and relay. Got a power on. Then you got some switches here, electric fuel fan, electric fuel pump, which I wired directly on this, and power pump. Make sure the fuel pump's lower than the level of the fuel tank, so it doesn't run dry. And you're going to follow up, turn on the pump, power power, and lift the starter, and lift into the water. How about that? So the auto air control brings the auto speed down. A good quality idle. Engine sounds great. I've got a set of mufflers on this, so it won't be too loud. And the throttle response is terrific. I'm not the gas pump. Settle down. The EVFI is a great way to go. If you want a carburetor, you know, you're living in a standard. They just worked on the car yesterday. Got a big old four barrel on it, a gallon style. No choke. Mechanical secondary. Take pickups up when the car is full, you get a left hand. To the drive, you can pop the back to the intake. With the EVFI, it's a speed engine system. Not sensor, engine cooling, temperature sensor. Distributed reference prices to get you fired up right there for the warmth up. The wideband oxygen sensor kicks in, maintains the best fuel mixture, it keeps the plugs clean, gives the best fuel economy you can get out of your hot rod. You fire it up cold, it goes into the hot rod, you drop it in the air, and there you go. There's a lot of features you can enable your cool fans to come on at certain temperatures and turn off. It's got an energy enabler, you turn on the air conditioning and street rod, set the engine start on equipment. So pick the auto, maintain it, it's a great way to go. Come on, just come in, get in the car there, go with me and get them in 4 or 5 hours, and you'll be running down the road. Remember, fast, easy, and yet fast. It's a great way to go.